Hello friends, today in continuation to my earlier videos, this is the third video I am going to post. We will be discussing today about the eclectic medicine in two parts. Part one would be about certain books and what is eclectic medicine, and if somebody wishes to go through eclectic medicine, how he should go about it, how to acquire knowledge and from where. And in the second part, we will be discussing about one or two medicine which is very useful at the time of hot summer to avoid any sort of sunstroke or its ill effects. So let us begin in the first part. As I already told, the eclectic medicine is not homeopathic medicine. Homeopathy is basically depends upon the history taking of a person and thereafter giving the drugs in high potency. High potency means that one drop of the original matter, maybe it is liquid, maybe it is in granules or in solid form, and thereafter it gets diluted, diluted and diluted again and again with the help of either alcohol or water, and that is being administered. If you know the Avogadro's principle, you know the higher the dilution, the lower its material content in the liquid form. So homeopathy principle is based on not to give any drug which is poor in its matter, rather dilute it and take out the energy out of it which goes into the water or the alcohol and then administer it. In homeopathy, not only this drug but also the case taking is different. Each of the drug, first symptom is mind and thereafter it goes to the physical body details, and based on the drug which satisfy most of the condition of a patient is only administered. But in eclectic medicine, it is not the case. In most of the cases, drugs are being given in most of its crude form. Number two is that it is given in repeat manner, and in homeopathy, it is given in an alternative manner. Very seldom somebody gives homeopathic drug each and every day. One dose in most of the cases are sufficient. But only problem is that in homeopathy, you have to have a very deep knowledge and absolutely sure about choosing a drug. A person might have various complications, but as per homeopathic principle, only one drug need to be administered. If any homeopathy person who is practicing the subject makes a list of the drugs and admix many drugs and then give to a patient, it is not as per the homeopathic principle. But I am not going to talk about homeopathy at all. It is the principle, what I understood, what I read, based on which my deliberations are. In eclectic medicine, the drugs are mostly in its common form as found and diluted very less, unless it is warranted. Number two is that the drug picture or the person who is suffering, his immediate condition is observed, like the allopathic doctor. If you have a frozen shoulder, that's enough, and the drug for the frozen shoulder is to be given. If you have a stomach pain, only the stomach pain is to be seen and the drug is to be given. The eclectic medicine has begun in the US in the early 18th century, and it was so popular. The common school which produces the allopathic doctor and the homeopathic doctor and the eclectic medicine people, later on they all dispersed in their own fields and the research get extended and people shift from the common school to different schools. In eclectic medicine, it is also called the definite medicine. Definite medicine is that when the person is sure about a drug, he only gives the sure shot remedy. So success rate in case of eclectic medicine is very high. Subject to that, the person who is examining, he must examine with a thorough knowledge of anatomy and physiology. Otherwise, the eclectic medicine cannot be given. But in case of homeopathy, in most certain cases, the knowledge of anatomy is less required, rather the symptoms are more important. Where you see the symptoms, open the books of homeopathy, find out a drug which shows the similar symptoms, and you find out a matrix where most of the symptoms in a particular drug is matching, and then you give the drug. Maybe one course is enough for that. But I must say it is a very challenging job, and if there are 1,000 people, only one can do those sort of miracle. But eclectic is not that complicated. If you have a problem, straight away, if you have a problem, the drug for A is to be given, and that's it. Now, if one has to start understanding the drug picture, the way the eclectic does and not as per homeopathy, then one has to study the books available, mostly publication by publishers who also publish homeopathy book. But you will not find much book about eclectic medicine. So it is very difficult to find out, because later on all eclectic medicine practice has slowed down into the US. But if anybody is interested, he can start with the homeopathy book itself, and the easiest book to start with, the Metria Medica. Metria Medica is nothing but a dictionary of the drugs available under homeopathy medicine. Homeopathy medicine has derived from three branches. So as eclectic medicine, so as arboreal medicine. Basically it is coming out of the nature. So nature has three ingredients out of which the drugs are being prepared. The number one is that it is from the botanical kingdom. So all the extract of the plant, leaves, flowers, etc., etc., all coming into the picture. Number two is that animal kingdom. So there might be drugs made out of the milk or from venom of the snakes, etc. Number three is that minerals like iron, zinc, copper, silver, etc. But you know the names like tin. In English it is called tin, but the Metria Medica and all these books, you can say the dictionary of the drugs, which is called Metria Medica, both for eclectic, both for Indian drugs, both for USA drugs or anywhere else, that is called Metria Medica in its official language. You can refer it as dictionary. It is alphabetical order, and each drug gives its detailed observations taken by the inventor of the drugs or the people who proved them on some samples, like 20-30 people, they have given some samples, and then they derived and recorded the provings, and that is being recorded in those dictionaries called Metria Medica. So you know the tin, which is called ferrum. You know the tin, which is called stannum. You know the iron, which is called ferrum. So on so forth. Copper is called cuprum. So you will see cuprum into the Metria Medica. It is nothing but the copper. You will see the stannum, which is nothing but the tin. You will see the ferrum, which is nothing but the iron. Everybody knows, if you have an anemia, any doctor, whether it is allopathy, homeopathy or anywhere, regardless of anything, they will give you iron tonic. And the same is that the ferrum in materia medica, in homeopathy or in eclectic. So drugs are same, and most of the drugs, there is no chemical drug as such in homeopathy or eclectic medicine, which has later on derived into the research laboratories and in most cases are within the domain of the allopathic medicine. But if you go into even the allopathic medicine, if you do not get your digestion well, you get certain type of carbon capsule prescribed by the doctors. And the same is that the carbo vegetables in the materia medica of homeopathic medicine and eclectic medicine. Only good thing is that in homeopathy and eclectic medicine, both, they give the medicine in such a form which can easily be absorbed by the body. So the side effects, what people generally refer, are close to nil. I don't say it is not there, but in most certain cases it is not affecting, or risk is very, very low. Now we will discuss it later on about the drug affinity, type of the drugs and so on so forth. Common names you know every day, like you know the turpentine oil, everybody use it in the doors and windows with the painting and all. Turpentine is one of the medicine very frequently used in case one is have any problem, special nephrological problem in homeopathy. Now if anyone who is interested at his home, or who is interested in gaining knowledge about homeopathy or eclectic medicine, though I must get it very clear that I am not talking about homeopathy, but I am just comparing whenever I took a reference of homeopathy, just for a comparison purpose and nothing else. So whoever wants to study the natural medicine, which I already elaborated, that is from the mineral kingdom, the plant kingdom and botanical kingdom and the animal kingdom. So first book of choice, the easiest book by which you can go through as per your interest, is the Materia Medica written by Dr. William Borick. What is Materia Medica? I must tell you first that this is, as I told you, is a dictionary which goes alphabetically A to Z, and all drugs are listed, and you have, as far as you can memorize it, you can be a better person who can understand the drugs well. So it starts with the mind and goes up to your leg and so on so forth. So I am having one book, I just want to show you the cover, that is the Materia Medica by William Borick. The book name is, complete name of the book is New Manual of Homeopathic Materia Medica and Repertory with Relationship of the Remedies by Dr. William Borick. But one thing I must tell you, that the book starts alphabetically, goes alphabetically, whether it is important drug or not important drug, it is not the matter, it starts from alphabetically. Say suppose in A there are 26 drug or 30 drug or 100 drug. The all 100 drugs are not important, only 3 or 4 are important, but you don't know what is important, what is not, that we will discuss it later on, so that you can skip other drugs basically. And I tell you, if you can remember at least 50 drug, you are a genius. By 50 drug you can do miracles. The second book I would like to refer to you is this book. This book is written by Dr. John Henry Clark, MD. And the book name is A Dictionary of Practical Materia Medica. It comes in 3 volumes. And this is a fantastic book. First book, as I told you, William Borick. That's it. It will take a very interested person to go through it for a year, 1 year complete. And thereafter, if he has doubts, he can refer this book. This man is a genius. I have visited his home as well in the UK. And after that, if somebody wants to go through the subject matter anatomically, here I would like to mention that the homeopathy medicine don't talk about anatomy much, like allopathic medicines. If you have any problem of heart, you will go to a doctor of heart disease. If you have a problem in your bones, you will go to an orthopedics. If you have a problem with your brain, you will go to neurosurgeon. He will never see your stomach. For the stomach, you have to go to gastroenterologist. But for arboreal medicine, eclectic and homeopathy, there is no gastroenterologist, there is no neurologist, there is no cardiologist, there is no orthopedic and etc. so on and so forth. One person has to treat whole of your body, because the basic principle of eclectic medicine, homeopathic medicine and arboreal medicine to treat the disease and the person as a whole and not organically. But yet, eclectic medicine treats the people organically. So that is the departure from homeopathy to the eclectic medicine. Here, we are not going to discuss about your mind or anything else, only the disease, and that's it. One or two drug will do everything under eclectic medicine. So diagnoses are sure shot and definite. Now, if still after these two book, one is grasping for more knowledge and having a more hunger and wants to see the drugs anatomically, for them this is the first book I would refer, this one. This book is The Principles and Practice of Homeopathy by Dr. Richard Hughes. Dr. Richard Hughes is LRCP, licentiate of Royal Society of Physicians, MRCS, member of Royal Society of Surgeons, and MD, and so on and so forth. He was physician of the kings. So this book is written by an allopathic doctor and not any homeopath. Similarly, the book I show you, Dr. Henry Clark, this book is also written by Dr. Henry Clark, MD. I told you earlier also that eclectic medicine school is the common school at that point of time, and any doctors passing out those schools having a degree of MD, and there are certain physicians who also had the degrees of Royal Societies like FRCS and MRCP, or the licentiate of Royal Society of Surgeons. So their books, as you can understand, as I told you, that the allopathic medicine goes anatomically and gives the drug based on anatomical problem. Similarly, this book by Dr. Richard Hughes is through anatomical findings. So in eclectic, while you don't need to know much about anatomy or physiology in homeopathy, though the current syllabus have that, but in eclectic medicine you have to have a certain knowledge about that, at least the basic understanding. So my part one is finished. Let us come to the part two, because I don't have much time, the video is getting longer and longer. In the part two, at this hot summer, especially if you live in a dry place where the hot wind blows and temperature goes soar up more than 50 degree, 48 degree, 30, and so on so forth, and dehydration problem is there, first and foremost thing that you should have lemon with little pinch of salt and glass full of water, at least 3 liters of water intake per day, and at least 2 glass of this lemon and pinch water. But if you happen to get sunstroke, the main symptoms of the sunstroke is that either the blood will rush to your chest or it will rush to your head, and you will feel very uneasy, and total the brain will be throbbing, and your eyes will go red, your ear will have tin 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 sounds, and your body will feel hot. You need immediately a cold weather, but that is not going to help you. Your thirst, you will not like to drink much water. Under these circumstances, one drug which comes immediate rescue, that is called glonine. I would like to spell you the name G, because in all the materia medicas they are written in some form or other. So some knows in one pronunciation, some talks about in a different pronunciation. So let me pronounce you all the names, whatever it has, just for a second. It is called GLONOINUM. Let me repeat once again, you can write it down. GLONOINUM. Gloninum. Gloninum. This is a nitroglycerin. Spirit of glycerinous nitrate. Gloninum or glonin, people call it. You can get it at any homeopathy shop with a power of 6. Keep it handy at your home or at your office. In case you have sunstroke and if you understand the symptom I already narrated, just take 2 drops immediately. Take some rest for half an hour and you will be all rescued. If this happens, there may be severe causes like stroke or any other bad damages to your heart or to your nerves of your brain. Take care. In that case, you can also use your umbrella to protect from the sun or use a hat. But glonin will always come to your rescue. Just buy 5 ml, keep it at your home. You can save your life with that. Thank you very much. We will see you again. And don't please forget to subscribe my channel and put a like button. And I will be encouraged by that. Thank you for your support. Thank you very much.